día. Día. ¿Cómo es?
Sometimes it's just good to sit back and watch and learn. Taking dogs on scented ground gets the heads down on them spaniels. And all three are spaniels, but one of the spaniels' job is completely different to the other two. Now, I want my spaniels working a lot closer. Dougie is supposed to open up, take in more ground, and go to point and flush on command. So he's learning on the job. And I can put as much pressure on them as I want to. But I don't want to put too much pressure on him. And yet he's got to have fun. He's got to be able to flush, else he thinks his job is over if he's not allowed to flush. So when he points like that and he shows me indication, I'm actually telling him to get on and find me the bird. Because I'm moving forward slowly with him, and yet now we're on game, he's going to come alive. If I didn't have the control beforehand with the way he was clearing off, he'd be gone 2-3 fields. So there's a compromise here for Jay, because that's his dog, and he's made some lovely comments about this today. And the dog's coming on, and it's important. But this dog can be a jack of all trades, and he needs to open up in open ground and tighten up in every cover. But the idea is, if I stifle him from going out a little bit further than I want my spaniels going out, I can cause all sorts of problems. Now, if you just did nothing but dogging in, your dogs would run straight lines. I don't want my dogs to run straight lines, but I'm doing a job for the keeper, and he's good enough to let us go across here and work this ground with lots of birds. See that there? I never punished Dougie. I asked Dougie to come back once the bird had taken off. I want to create that excitement and then put the control in. The amazing thing about technology these days, you can actually get the mule to follow you with a click of a button. It just put it in drive and it actually follows you about 2 miles an hour. Saves you walking back up the hill. It's a fantastic bit of kit. Fantastic bit of kit. And the dogs love it. And that's what they're doing. We're dogging in. And we're letting them roam, we're letting them open up, we're letting them take in more room than they would normally, because we're taking Dougie with us. But look how the spaniels still stay close, because they've been conditioned. Dougie's learning on the job, and that's how he can learn, on the job. Sometimes you've got to get out there and let him do it. and he's lifting his head and he's winding and then he's pulling and he's walking up into it. And then when I say go, he can chase them. Simple as that.
How you feeling, Paddington? How you feeling? Nice blue skies, Paddington. Can you get any dressed up any warmer?
I love working two dogs in the woods. I really enjoy working two dogs in the woods. And at the end of the day, it gives them a bit of competition, but it also teaches them to hunt tighter. So when they're in the woods with me here, I want them to hunt tighter and closer. It depends which way the wind's blowing, but I still want them to put their heads down. And like I say, because we've been dogging in this morning, look at the heads down on these dogs. They automatically have their heads down, but they're just drilling it rather than running around. And that's what I want to do. The more these dogs, these two dogs, find this season, the better they will become. They're nice and tight. They're stopping on the whistle sharp. They want to play the game. They enjoy the game. And it's been done the Corleone way, through gameplay and 5% discipline. 5% discipline. And yet these dogs are having the time of their lives out there. I can work a pack of dogs because I've conditioned these dogs to stay nice and tight and have the fun with me. That's why they want to stay with me. At this point, Sue sat in the mule because it was a little bit windy on top of the woods here. But I just wanted to give these two a run through the woods after they've been running around the fields. I wanted to get their heads down and get them a bit tighter. Finish off with a bit more tight hunting look. And they're very inexperienced for their age. But this year, these dogs will be shot over big time. Because last year I shot over them and protected them. This year they're going to be shot over big time. And they're going to take Wizard's place. Eventually one of these will be sold. And he will take Wizard's place. Because now Wizard's getting an old boy. And I want a young dog coming on. So I'll turn him into a superstar. And because I've kept two, I've got a choice. But I can't really split them. They're both different. The liver-headed one is more driven. Got more naughtiness in him, but I like his temperament. The other one is soft and natured and a very biddable dog, and he looks at me a little bit more. He's more honest. And some people say, oh, if a dog's looking at you when you're casting it off and you're hunting, he looks at me so much more, but not when he's on proper scent. In this wood there's no birds. We didn't come across any birds, and he's looking at me if you see again. But once he got into that situation with a scent on the ground, these dogs don't look at you, trust me. But he's more honest than the other dog. And yet he's very driven as well. Very driven. I love his nature. I could take either of these two dogs and turn them into winners in competition. Because they're just both really, really nice. Both quality. No faults. And they're a pleasure to own. But I've not rushed them. And that's the important thing. I keep trying to say to people, you know, if you've only got one dog, you can sort of rush it because you can't wait. You haven't got time to wait, or you need a dog desperately. I don't. At the end of the day, I'm training people's dogs. I'm training my dogs. And Wizards, you know, a dog will go well for 10 years, hopefully. And then after that, you've got to start thinking about getting your next dog in. That's the whole point. Get your next dog in. So I hope you enjoyed that. And it just gave you an insight into what happened this morning. There was a lot more on there, but I've just edited it down just to show you clips of different things, what happened. I haven't got time to go through and put it all and edit it all. I just did a quick run through of showing you what we were doing today. But it was pouring with rain this morning, and then the sun come out, and we didn't. And the wind was there, so it was quite nice. It was great for the dogs. Finished off with a swim for them, as you can see. Look at big, brave old motorcycle rider Dougie. He's not that keen to get in the water, so I have to get in the water to show him what I want him to do. And I'll come in, but can I come in this way? Can I get in? Oh, there you go. Oh, I got wet then. Did you see that? I got wet. Did you see it? I got wet. But he's getting better. He's getting better by being stronger, as the song goes, eh? As the song goes, getting better by being stronger. He could be Rocky, couldn't he? Where's he gone now? Anyway, that's the end of that.